Assalamu alaikum friends, welcome to Rizwana's Rasoi. Today we are going to make a very special dish right from Malaysia, which is mostly made among Asians, and this is called as Jalar Appam, also called as the Malaysian crepe. So the main ingredients for this dish are all-purpose flour. I have taken around 400 grams of all-purpose flour. Then there's around 250 ml of coconut milk. Along with that, we'll be taking a pinch of turmeric powder. This is optional. Again, we'll be taking ghee or oil, clarified butter, anything of your choice. Then there's salt, one egg and water to make the batter. This is the jalar cup that we'll be using to make the jalar, and this is available in any departmental store. So let's get started with the procedure. So here I have taken the all-purpose flour. Along with this, we will crack an egg. Then goes in the coconut milk. Make sure you incorporate all the ingredients well. And now it's time to add water, little by little, till there are no lumps. Make sure that the batter is not too runny, not too thick. You can add water little by little to check the consistency. Now add some salt as per your taste and together with this add just a pinch of turmeric, not too much because you would like to retain its mild yellowish color, and give it a mix. Now still we are not sure because it must be free of lumps. When you are pouring it through your jalar cup, it should be flowing freely. So for that reason, we will be now grinding it in a mixer and passing it through a filter. So I have grinded the mixture in the mixer and now I would just filter it in order to ensure that there are no lumps. The main thing in making this jalar is to get this consistency. So make sure that there are no lumps. And you should get a free flowing batter. Should be not too thin, not too thick. In order to ensure that your consistency is just right, you can just pour it through your jalar cup and see. It is free flowing without any bubbles. Okay, now the batter is ready and we can start making the jalar. Now just heat the pan and for the first few to make sure that it doesn't stick to your dosa tawa, you can just grease it with a bit of oil or ghee. So I'll just show you how to make a jalar appam. So I have just filled in the cup with the required amount and just hold the nozzle at the other end so that it doesn't pour off, and just you need to go round and round like a jalebi. Make sure that the circles are a little closer and not too far, and don't make it too thick as well. Go for a few rounds and you can then just apply a little ghee. Ghee is more preferable because it gives you a nice aroma. The cooking time for this is quite short. You need not wait for long. You just see some dark color coming on the other side, and this need not be flipped as well. Okay, so now we can see that it is browning from the other side. You need not keep it for long. Just with one hand you can lightly remove it and keep it. I'll show you one more. Keep the wrist motion quite slow. You be like too fast, then there are chances that your jala can tear apart. So I have put one more on the tawa, and I can see this brown spots coming here and there. You can even fold this in a conical shape and serve it. So here we go, friends. This is jala appam. Try this at home. This goes very well with any kind of mutton gravy or chicken gravy. And it is traditionally had for Eid, which can be had on other days as well. So give it a try. If you like my recipe, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you, friends.